out is, what kind of weed control do we get from some of these cover crop species? If you'll turn to page 29, I have just kind of a summary graph there that shows some data on winter annual weed control. So we want to know, obviously these cover crops are going to have the greatest effect on these winter annual weeds, but what exactly is it? So if you'll look at this, this is averaged across 5 sites in over 2 years. So this gives us a pretty good average of the numbers we've been seeing. You can see there, cereal rye and hairy vetch did pretty well on the winter annual weeds, and then cereal rye did pretty well also. So those are some ones that stand out to us as having a significant impact on our weed control on winter annual weeds. Now, more importantly, let's shift gears, turn to page 35.
Explain to him this, because this data comes right out of what he's standing in front of. And I asked him to cut out this little semicircle here just to kind of show some of that. So explain what you did here.
Yeah, so what we want to show here is, here on the right, we have just a hair touch. So that's something that winter kills, and we don't have a lot of biomass above ground. Here is a cereal rye with the hairy vetch mix, and you can see all of this straw on top of the ground, which is part of the reason we get this benefit of weed control from something that has this much biomass. It's kind of, we kind of have two reasons for this weed control. It's been proven, some research has shown that cereal rye has an allelopathic ability, which means it releases some gases that prevent other weeds from emerging. So we have that, and then we also have the aspect of ground cover. So there's two reasons why cereal rye stands out to us and has an effect on weed emergence. And then, like I said, that's on winter annual weeds, but also we've seen significance for it on summer annual weeds. If you'll look on page 35, like I said, we have the same type of graph, so over 5 sites on the same trials, and now we're looking at summer annual weeds. And you can see, compared to our non-treated control, that cereal rye definitely made a difference. And even compared to a fall herbicide residual treatment, we had some significant reduction in weed emergence. So that's something that we want to consider. From us looking at this from a weed control aspect, trying to figure out what do we gain from this throughout the growing season for suppressing weeds, cereal rye is one that definitely stands out to us. Whether it be in that cereal rye hairy vetch mix, or whether it be cereal rye by itself. Now, for summer annual weeds, the mix did not do as well, so the cereal rye with the vetch did not do quite as well. I kind of think that has to do with a little bit of intercompetition. We don't have quite as much straw on top of the ground throughout the summer with that mix, but we had a little more with cereal rye just by itself, so it might have just gotten a little taller by itself, so that's something to consider. A survey was taken, and the fourth main reason for why people were using cover crops was due to the fact that they were looking for some additional weed control. So like Jamie said, on his project, it's another tool that we can keep in mind to use in our control of some of these problematic weeds.